everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. This is Madden 18 on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Carson Wentz's Eagles going up against Cousins' Redskins. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth as we turn it over to Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
We are just inside the Beltway, about 10 miles east of the Capitol Dome, as we come to you from FedEx Field here in Landover. Just a few moments ago, it was the Redskin defense being introduced, and the largest cheers went for their Pro Bowl quarterback, Josh Norman, as he and his guys get set to do battle with Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles. Hi again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And you know, Charles, as Larry pointed out in the open, got a couple of great quarterbacks set to square off here this afternoon. That ball's probably going to be flying all over the place, isn't it?
Oh, without a doubt. And the game has never been more quarterback-centric than it is now. And both of these teams have top-flight signal callers.
Caleb Sturgis now to do the honors and get us started. And we are underway from FedEx Field. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. So out comes the Redskins offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by the veteran quarterback out of Michigan State. The former Spartan, it's Kirk Cousins.
I think he just gets better and better. He was third in the NFL in passing yardage in 2016. In fact, over the last two seasons, over 9,000 yards passing, the fourth most in the NFL.
Yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Keep it in the hands of Kelly, and he'll get this one up to the 26. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. And here a look at the offensive starters for the Redskins.
The Washington offense in 2016 ended up ranked in the top five in the NFL. In fact, they have number three overall. So how did they get it done? Well, head coach Jay Gruden, he's the guy who's really the master play caller. He's known for his ability to throw the football, but he'd love to run it. They were only number 21 in the league in 2016, coupled with number two in throwing the ball. If they're able to get their running numbers up, they could really be dangerous in 2017.
Cousins the thrower. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Jordan Hicks in there to drop him for a 4-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack. Now the fourth-year man from Oklahoma, Tress Way, on to punt. Back deep is Darren Sproles. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Call that one an even 60 yards, 6-0. And the Eagles take possession. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. Leading them is their second-year quarterback, also the number two overall pick a season ago, Carson Wentz.
Many wondered if the Eagles gave up way too much to get the number two pick from Cleveland in order to draft Carson Wentz. But after his freshman campaign in the NFL, I think people believe they see positive signs from a big, strong-armed guy, an intelligent guy, and a really competitive player.
first carry for LeGarrette Blount. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. And the tight end, Zach Ertz, is key in this offense as we get a look at the starters.
Comes out of the factory known as Stanford, which keeps putting out tight ends. Zach Ertz, one of the better ones we've seen in recent years.
So second and nine, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here. Working from the gun, Wentz. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Go Wentz to Blount here. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take it the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
Again, here's Blount, and he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, add that play to his resume reel because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
On second down, here's Wentz. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And now a look at the Washington defense.
There were high hopes in Washington in 2016 as they expected their defense to ascend into a top 10 type of a unit. Instead, it was a struggle all season long. So they had to retool this pass off season, and they're going to start with trying to lock down the running game. Very tough to do in the NFC East, and if they do that, maybe their Pro Bowl cornerback, Josh Norman, will have more opportunities out on the corner.
Now Wentz on third down. And avoids the contact by sliding. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So the offense has it first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
They'll run again with Blount. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Already a pair of third down conversions for them on this drive, but right now they need 5 yards on this third down try. And that is incomplete. Donnie Jones set to punt it away now in his 14th year in the NFL. Back deep for the Redskins, Jamison Crowder. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. The Redskins offense now, they head back onto the field. And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
The drive starts with Rob Kelly. Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4. And we peek at the defense now for Philadelphia.
In 2016, the Eagles showed that they were going to be aggressive on defense. A lot of man coverage and send the pass rushers after the quarterback. I don't expect that to change at all in 2017, but they are looking for increased play from their cornerbacks trying to lock down some wide receivers.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here.
Tight end to the right, boy. Tight end to the right. Hey, hey,
hey. Hunt. They'll go again with Kelly. Broke a tackle, but not much room there ultimately. Just up past the 25 and no further. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's 3rd down.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football getting away from one and trying to churn forward and get some yardage. I really liked what he did there.
So following the run, we'll see what they do here on 3rd down. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. It's brought in by Dodson. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pickup there on 20 yards.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Play fake here on 1st down. It's brought in by Jamison Crowder. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A very solid gain of 27.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right, because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
It's a nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They go play action here on 1st down. That's brought in by Davis over the middle. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 11 more on that one and another first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
So here we go, first and 10 now. On the run, it's Kelly, and he'll get about three as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Play fake, Cousins. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Fletcher Cox continuing to fight downfield. The big tackle gets him for a loss of 11.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
Cousins with work to do after the sack as he brings his guys up on a third and long. From the gun, here's Cousins. Escapes the sack. This will be caught inside the 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. First and goal, Kelly. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Second and goal. Defense digging in again here. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. That'll go as a loss of 5. And that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable. And you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. This offense so far on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at a third and goal here. And before they can get settled in here, time expires on the first quarter of action. 0-0 our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number 2. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. The Redskins on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and goal. Working out of the gun, Cousins. That escapes the sack. But in the end, the pressure too great, and he goes down. Timmy Jernigan in there to drop him for a 4-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
So on fourth down, Cousins will head to the sideline and give way to Dustin Hopkins. And Hopkins' kick is good. And it's 3-0 as the Redskins strike first. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
Following the made field goal for 3, Hopkins now to kick it off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it. And they'll take it out to the 25. We focus our attention on the Redskins' defense now. They're hoping to do what they did last time, force another punt. Last time it resulted in a field goal. We'll see if they can get another stop here, though.
And the best defenses are in the business of preventing points and creating points. And that's exactly what these guys did on their last possession. Why? Because they got off the field on 3 and out, turned the ball over to their offense after the punt, and let them roll downfield and put the ball through the post for a field goal.
Start on the ground here with Blount. And Blount loses the football. And the Redskins scoop it. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Now the Redskins offense, they get set to go back to work here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
They run with it. It's Kelly. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. This is Kelly. Sharp move, but can't find much space. Dropped just inside the 20. 4 yards on the pickup there, as it'll leave him with a third and about 4 more for a first.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
The Redskins on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. On play action, Cousins. into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now, and I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
Begin here with Blunt. He'll get about three as he's taken down at the 23.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
So under the category of, while it can't be us because we're not that good, but could you imagine if this was you? LeGarrette Blount, his first 1,000-yard season since, what, 2010, his rookie year, and 18 touchdowns in the regular season? And no longer with New England.
He is over 30 now. He turned 30 in December. I don't know if that played a factor, but yeah, such a productive year, and then he's gone.
Well, that just tells you this. Now he's going to be playing with a chip on his shoulder, trying to prove something.
Wentz now giving to Blunt on the draw. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. Because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Now they'll throw it. Wentz. Ertz over the middle. And Eagle first down. Wentz to Ertz.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
To Sproles, wins, and he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40 and give him 17 yards that time, as that'll move the chains.
I know they don't like to hear it when they get to a certain age, but then you have to start to use your skills, your wiles, right, your mind to beat guys to the football, and getting your toes tapped in bounds definitely qualifies as that, doesn't it?
The veteran showing he still has the agility. Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved.
False start, offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards.
Still first down.
So now first and 15. Sproles. He takes this for about 6 down inside the 40.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get four here down to the 35-yard line.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. This is Johnson, he's got it. Touchdown, Philadelphia. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. Now it's Chris Thompson on the return. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. Here's Kirk Cousins now, the centerpiece of our player spotlight. And I guess the question, Charles, is what's the formula for keeping him better protected? Because as we see, the protection, it struggled.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground, but that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
And we'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Looking left sideline. Incomplete. Jordan Reed was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. It goes as a loss of 6. And now third down.
I'm getting the sense that Fletcher Cox is making offensive linemen want to take the week off when they have to play against him.
It's a regular routine for him, isn't it?
It really is. That play there, that's him all day long. Good luck trying to block him and keep him from disrupting your offense.
The Redskins on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 16. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Tressway now. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Now Sproles. Sproles so quick and agile. Oh, and now he bowls him over. Darren Sproles, the 20. And he takes it all the way, but there is a flag down, so hold the celebration. This one's coming back.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
So a special team's mistake on a long punt return.
And think about the momentum that leaks out after that play, right? It's built up, terrific return, everyone's excited, but that flag on the ground can bring it way, way back.
Now Blunt. Oh, he bowls over him. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Now a play fake. Wentz. Blitz coming and down he goes. Ryan Kerrigan not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. Caught by the tight end Ertz. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And now a first down following that long gain. From the gun, it's Wentz. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Throwing on first is Wentz. He finds Aguilar over the middle. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
Wentz now to throw. That is caught at the 7. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the 2. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. From the 2-yard line now, it's first and goal. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. Second and goal to go now. They'll go to Blunt, try and pound it in. And he will take this one in for an Eagle touchdown. LeGarrette Blunt taking it in. And the Eagles add on to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. That time, a 9-play drive. And it ends in a touchdown run by LeGarrette Blunt. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. This one fielded at the 5. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. There's Rob Kelly now as he and the offense head back out. He's had a good chunk of carries. Problem is, for very little success. I don't want to put it all on his shoulders, but that's a big reason they're losing right now.
Have to be very careful that he doesn't start pointing fingers. Offensive line obviously trying. The defense is doing a nice job against him today. When it's all said and done, it's all about the guy in the mirror. He has to get it done better going forward.
See if he can look and do some soul searching now.
Single, single. Single, single.
first down throw for Cousins. And a hookup over the middle to Pryor. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as they'll stop him with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gaughan alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes a timeout, and now we're set to get going. Now the offense lining up, first and 10. Now Cousins. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. A second down throw for Cousins. He'll leave it for Kelly, complete. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout, as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. To the air again. It's Cousins. Jordan Reed has it. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Again, it's Cousins. Now the hit comes, and Cousins lost the football. So we've reached halftime here, and it's our visitors, the Eagles, leading this one, as we send you down to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Redskins are behind right now, but the home crowd should give them a boost. The Eagles have looked good on the road and will just try to keep the ball rolling in the second half. All right, let's do this. Here's the first half highlights. Now following the fumble, here the defense will come up with the pick. Eagles defense forces the turnover. After the pick, offense comes out now. Wentz has got the completion here, and he caps off the 7-play drive with a score. The lead grows to 4. We move late into the second. Lutz got it on the run, and he'd cap off the 8-play drive with a TD. The lead now at 11.
All right, Larry, these two teams back out there as we get set and ready for this second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This one fielded at the five. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as he'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. The drive starts with a handoff to Blum, and able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Second down following the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. The Eagles on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and eight. Shotgun now for Wentz. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Here's Donnie Jones now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. ...46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. So now we look at the Redskins offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. They'll start on the ground with Kelly. And nice yardage right off the bat here as he's up to about the 24-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Second down, Cousins. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays. Three,
Now a play fake here on first down. Incomplete. He was trying to get it there to Vernon Davis, the tight end. And now it's second down. Well, not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Throwing again, Cousins on second and 10. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. The Redskins on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and 10. They'll throw again. Cousins. And Reed with it over the middle. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Cousins to his big target. Reed and the Redskins have a first down.
I don't think there's any question that Jordan Reed is as athletic as any tight end in the league. All right, I don't think there's any debate about that. The hard part is just him being able to be healthy.
And when he's on the field, though, boy, does he take them to another level, doesn't he?
He certainly does. Changes the game for them because they can use him in so many different spots and create mismatches against the defense.
A give. This is Kelly. And he's got this one just across midfield to the 49. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Second down, just 1 yard to go. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll get it down here to the 43. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
Here on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Touchdown, Washington. Brian Quick, 43 yards. And the Redskins have made this a one-score game. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
And they will line up now for the 2-point try. Out of the gun, Cousins toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite, but in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a 2-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. Able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 8 yards on the run, and that cuts us down to a third and about 5.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. The Eagles on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This will be 3rd and 5. Working from the gun, Wentz. And that's caught by Smith. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Wentz to his new target, Smith for an Eagle first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 2nd and a foot or so.
That was a good, strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got it. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
Second down, here's Wentz. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time. And it's 3rd down. A little too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
The offense on 3rd down tonight, they've been very good. 5 for 7 thus far. They're looking at 3rd and the nose of the football. To throw is Wentz, and unable to connect. If he had caught it, it would have been a 1st down. Instead, it's 4th.
I wonder, Brandon, I just wonder, you think maybe he was worried about where he was on the field? Was he far enough? Was he close enough to the 1st down sticks?
Absolutely. He was right there by him, and I think he was thinking 1st down before he caught that football.
Yeah, got to catch it first, because if you don't catch it, there's no chance of picking up a 1st down.
Here's Donnie Jones now, as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. Scrimmage and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you're talking about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big time play there.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll power his way up near the 25. Call it a gain of four, and it'll leave him with a third down and six to go.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
The Redskins on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This will be third and six. Throwing his Cousins. Now they go screen. It's complete. That good for 19 on a first down.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensing the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Tough day, tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
The Redskins on third down, 5 out of 9 thus far. This is third and 7. Now Cousins. And incomplete. Almost intercepted. The D lineman almost had it. Couldn't hang on.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Here's Tressway now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he'll keep this one away from Sproles as this is angled toward the sideline. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line. Carson Wentz and the Eagles make their way out to the field. How do you break down his game so far? Just the one touchdown pass, but sometimes the touchdown pass stat category, that doesn't tell the whole story.
It really doesn't, not until you balance it with the error side, you know, and in this case, he hasn't thrown any interceptions. So a lot of people would call this almost a pedestrian game, kind of a bus driver game, but that's just really wrong. Being a bus driver is a good thing if you're running a football team because that means you're in control and you're taking your team to the right places.
Yeah, he's been pretty solid. Now a carry for Bonner. And he'll be taken down, losing yardage back at the 9-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
So slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that.
Well, he was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
Now Wentz on third down. Completes it to Aguilar. And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. We've played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now at FedEx Field. It's the Eagles in possession of the football and leading this one as we get ready to start the final quarter. Here's Donnie Jones now, standing just outside his own goal line. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. Burst by him near the 35. Just a yard return there after a punt of 49. And the Redskins will take possession with a first and 10. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs, and that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Down. Here's Cousins. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
So a challenge is upon us. I tell you, close game, fourth quarter. This is a huge decision.
Oh, no doubt about that, partner. A lot has to be riding on this call. And you know it is a tight one because it has to be indisputable visual evidence in order to change it. Now here's the big question. Do they actually have that evidence?
We're about to find out. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Fresh set of downs here. The gun. Here's Cousins. Wide open receiver complete. And he eventually goes down, but not before reaching the 30-yard line. A good pickup there, 22. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did.
Cousins on first down. The swing pass caught and out of bounds all the way down at the 2-yard line.
Holding offense.
Well, your QB's been sacked four times in the game already. And they're the holding goal.
And you know darn well the offensive line coach is frustrated and upset that he's been hit that many times already. He doesn't really care that they hold now. Just don't let him get hit anymore.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. On play action, Cousins. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Jordan Hicks in there to get him. His second sack now of the afternoon.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Second down throw for Cousins. Staying on his feet, fights loose, and the pressure gets to him again. Vinny Curry in there to get him, and this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Cousins to throw it. Got his man over the middle. This is quick. Touchdown, Washington. Brian Quick, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Redskins have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
Well, we've seen some lead changes, and it certainly appeared that one of these squads was in full control of the game, but that's not the case after that touchdown.
Yeah, they erase a 2-TD deficit here to grab the lead. So here are the Redskins now, an important two-point conversion. Cousins, and he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead. So they make the decision. They want a three-point lead versus a two-point lead, and they got it.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, it seems like the exact right thing to do. Put a little pressure on your defense, but the biggest thing now is you're making the other team chase you.
Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Wentz now on first down. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Second down following the incompletion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. Here's Donnie Jones now. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. It's a 46-yard punt, two on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. But they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. Kelly tries the right side, and he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. The Redskins on third down. They've converted six times and could use a seventh here. This is third and four. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. It's brought in by Doxson. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. Really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Watch left, watch left. Double, double here. Hey,
To throw, Cousins. Able to shake him off. He's going to air one out. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to, you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle it yourselves.
I like that, yeah. There was contact. I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though.
And on second and 10 now. Throwing, Cousins. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Fletcher Cox getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
Cousins with work to do after the sack as he brings his guys up on a third and long. Here's Cousins. To the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and that's going to make it fourth down.
I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense back out onto the field.
Now, if you're a fan of punting, and I know that not many people are, but this game kind of turning into one for you.
Well, it's okay if it's a skills contest, right? We're really into it then, but not during the course of an actual game. This has turned into a field position game, though. Sometimes a better punter may actually determine the outcome.
Down, Wentz. And a reception made by Alshon Jeffrey. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. They've really been able to contain Alshon Jeffrey. That catch, a rare exception in this game.
And that's a feather in their cap because he's such a tone setter for his team on offense that they try and get him the ball early. And, of course, what comes after that is often. And for them to limit him and him not catch a ball until the second half, it's a big reason why his team is behind on the scoreboard.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Preston Smith. Coming in from that outside linebacker spot to bury him for a loss of 7.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Wentz to throw on second down. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs.
So the offense has it first and 10. From the gun, it's Wentz. Going underneath to Blunt. And he'll get it down here to the 43. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. Incomplete, almost intercepted. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. Play action to Sproles. Wentz. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Zach Brown in there to get him for a loss of 9, and that'll lead to fourth down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
One score down, here we go. They're gonna go for it here on fourth down. Now Wentz, gotta have this one. This is Johnson, he's got it. 30 yards on the pickup there. And that leads to a Philadelphia first. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. So here we go, first and 10 now. To throw is Wentz. Screen pass to Blunt. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. First down now, but that clock rolling. Back to throw. And he slides to avoid the hit. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll be second down. Clock running here, under 90 seconds to go. He'll look to throw. Incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
The Eagles on third down. They've converted 5 times in their many chances thus far. This is third and 4. Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved.
False start, offense.
The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
The Eagles on third down. They've converted 5 times in their many chances thus far. This is third and 9.
back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Matt Ioannidis in there to take him down, and the clock will roll.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to tie things up in the final minute. And Sturgis able to knock it through. And that will tie this game here in the final minute of play. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net. But they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This one taken from the 7. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. They need to get this around the 40 to have a chance to win it in regulation. From the 40, it's a 57-yard field goal, so that gives you a gauge.
And all they're trying to do now is pick up yardage in good chunks and get out of bounds to stop the clock. If they end up running a play and get tackled in bounds, they're worried the clock may run out on them and finish the game.
And they'll have to be careful how they handle this. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Now Cousins. And his throw is incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Here's Cousins. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Fletcher Cox. Who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Here's Tressway now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. So four quarters wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dial. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. They're set for their first drive here in overtime, and this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets double, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team, and that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. They go play action here on first down. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Burton. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 15 yards through the air and a first down. So they come out throwing in the extra session and get a nice hookup right away.
Tells you a lot about what a coach feels about his team, doesn't it? That type of a play in overtime. So many people in this situation play not to lose instead of playing to win. That throw there tells you exactly what they're trying to get done.
To the offense lining up first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. To the right side, caught by Salek. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. So he hooked up with a veteran there, and in overtime, that's not a bad idea. Go with the age and the experience.
Yeah, because sometimes the young guys, they give you the fresh legs and give you all that bounce. But in this type of a situation, sometimes those legs slow down a little bit as the enormity of the moment overwhelms them. The veteran guys, they tend to come through.
They fake the give. Now wins. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Stacy McGee in there to record another sack. Their sixth of the afternoon.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
Second down, here's Wentz. Ertz over the middle. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Well, a little dinking and dunking that they're doing. At some point, is it appropriate to maybe take a shot?
It is, if you feel good about it. But otherwise, you do what a coach told me a long time ago. Take what they give you, but make them tackle. In other words, get it to one of your guys in space. If he makes someone miss, that could turn into the big play you're looking for.
On third and long, it's Wentz. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Terrell McClain in there with pressure yet again, and that's the seventh time they've dropped him here this afternoon.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
Here's Donnie Jones now on for a very important punt here in overtime. The kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is 3, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it.
but they turned it back over to him, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
Yeah, part one is done. Now part two. Now a handoff here to his running back. Only able to get it to his own 20 after breaking through the contact. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. Well, winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game, but when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
What can Cousins do in the OT? And Davis with it left side. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down. Well, he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. Jordan Reed has it. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Charles, you get into these overtime situations, that's not a bad guy to dial into.
Well, when you have to have plays, especially in a spot as you just described, we're an OT, you've got to go to the guys you can trust and you know are going to make the plays. Well, they say, it's not the X's and the O's, it's the Jimmys and the Joes.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Cousins completes it right side to Doxson, and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That's their second and last timeout here in the overtime session. We'll be back. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and 8.
Double tight, guys. Double tight.
Hey. Yo.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. They've had some success here in overtime in this opening drive running the football right back to that well.
And why not? When you have that kind of success, make them stop you. And until they do, keep going back to that well you just spoke about. I think there's more water there available to them.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. And again this time to the tailback. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. And he'll give it here to his running back. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He gets them a little over half of what they needed. Now they're looking at a 3rd and 5.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
On the ground, it's Thompson down to the 25. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be 4th down. And that carry, probably not so much for yardage, just to get the spot that you want to kick the field goal.
And any yardage you gain there is really kind of gravy. And this just becomes what my old coach used to say. Get into position to be in position. And that's what they want, the right spot for their kicker to line up the field goal.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. Made his first. This now from 42 yards out. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. And he got it. The kick is good in overtime. He's able to split the uprights. We were just
just treated to an absolute dandy in this one. A great finish in overtime with a long field goal. Everybody, including us, on the edge of their seats. Quite a game.
And it's rare that you get a game into overtime that it doesn't turn out to be a dandy, right? That's what we saw here. And just what you were talking about, a long field goal to win it. So definitely not a gimme. So there was tension all the way through until the ball went through the post.
But it did go through the